Hey there guys, my name is Luke Pivot and I'm predominantly a writer at airentertainment.com. Today I'm going to be taking a bit of a different approach with this title. We've been sent a review copy over by our friends at Curve Digital. This game has been developed by Runner Duck, and if it looks at all familiar, then it is the sequel to their previous title, Bomber Crew, which was also a great success. They take a different approach with their game style, and they brand their own game as a strategic space survival simulation. And what that is essentially, it has RPG elements to it. You build your crew, you level them up, you build your ship up, and you go on all missions to improve them. But then it has this high risk, high reward system. You can either slug your way through lower missions, which are fairly easy to accomplish until you get to a progressed state to be able to just tackle whatever lays bare in front of you. Alternatively, it gives you the option to really challenge yourself and get more rewards from doing this and progress faster, but with it comes more of a challenge. Essentially, what happens is if you take a big risk, then you run the danger of losing your squad or losing your ship, should I say. What that means is if a member of your crew dies, they're gone. If your ship blows up with your crew on board, it's all gone. You have to start again. So this game supports a number of languages. There is obviously English, there is French, German, Spanish, Japanese, Korean, Polish, Russian, simplified Chinese, and traditional Chinese. So if English isn't your predominant language or isn't your main language, then this game is fairly accommodating for that. So without further ado, let's load up my save and I'll introduce you to my crew. Okay, so this is Captain Luke Pillar, named after the one and only. He's 44 years old. His favourite colour is turquoise. I'd argue against that. His hometown is also Barcelona, which is a very unique name for a Spanish native. Then we've got Finn Rose, who's 37 years old. Previous occupation is catering. Her hobby is calligraphy. Then you have James Santos, which is 27 years old. His favourite food is burritos. His hobby is crosswords. Then you have Ines Wright. Don't know if I'm saying that right. Ines Wright. Ines. She is 26 years old. Her hometown is Shenzhen. Favourite colour, purple. I don't know if I just called Rose a man, but apologies. And then below that you've got Benjamin Kovalchuk, who is 38 years old. His hometown is Cairo, apparently. Previous occupation is asteroid mining. And finally, last but not least, you've got Maria Bonilla. She's 27 years old, favourite food is pizza, and her favourite colour is red. If you haven't established, these characters are generated as the game is made. You can rename them, you can customize them, you can change the way they look. I'll have a quick show you through all that. Okay, I've made her a bloke. Hold on. Sorry, Maria. There you go. Had a nice haircut, but okay, so basically all the crew have their own unique roles. At level 6, you get to branch out into a second skill, which I've reached that stage. So my captain, he is in charge of flying the ship. He also has a secondary role, which I'll cover when I reach the comms officer. So he is secondary comms officer. Oh, there we are. Okay, Finn Rose. She is a comms officer, so it is her job to essentially, she can scan things, she can call in fighter support. There's a number of skills that she can do. Then you have the engineer, who he carries out the ship's repairs. He can boost the reactor, which increases the power output to individual, like the weapons, the shields, anything like that. The gravity generator. But then you have security officer. The security officer can essentially take out parts of the ship. He can detract them from the ship. He can launch them off into space in order to preserve. So it basically sucks them out into the vacuums of space, so this can end up killing enemies, it can end up killing your crew. It's almost like a last resort, in a sense. Then you have a weapons officer there. You have two weapons officers, which are the gunners of the ship. So they essentially just improve at blasting phasmids, essentially. Phasmids are the enemy in the game. They're the enemy agents. And then again, going back to everyone at level 6 unlocks a second role. There can only be one captain, but all the other roles can have somebody else that have a this sub-focus. I'll have a quick look at my spaceship. It is the Sentry Eagle. It's got some upgraded armor plates ready to tackle any aliens. We've got the high-capacity shields. So a high capacity shield recharger, it creates very strong shields but has a slow recharge rate. Then you have a gravity generator MK2, an improved gravity generator. It's got a bit of armoring and is less likely to break down, so it's more there for reliability. Then you've got the oxygen generator MK2, an improved oxygen generator. It's got a bit of armoring and is less likely to break down. So when your ship gets under fire and your shield gets depleted, what happens is parts of your ship start getting damaged. And this is where the engineer comes into play. He has to fix the broken parts as they get damaged. Otherwise, they just don't work. So if your oxygen generator doesn't work, then it's harder for your players to get, hard for your characters to get around the ship. And also what it does is it leaks radiation into the ship, which, not so much the oxygen generator, but the main reactor there, that leaks a thing called radiation, and the engines do as well. They leak radiation into the ship, which kills your crew as if it goes neglected. Then we have the medical bay. So when your crewmates get injured, that's where they go. It takes a while to do, so it's best to do when you're out of combat. There's also, throughout the ship, they've got numerous fire extinguishers, space suits to go outside and fix the engines. They've got med kits, and they've got rifles, because the phasmids have boarding ships, which essentially just, they go in through the cargo there, and they go and start shooting at your crewmates. Escape pods. So, like I was saying about earlier, where when your crew dies, they're gone. So, if you want to preserve these crew, if there's a person that's your favourite, obviously mine will be Captain Pillar the Great, then he will go into the escape pod where he will launch. I have never been in a situation where I've had to do this, so I can't say what it does, but as far as I'm aware, it will leave them into space where they can, it will launch them into space where they can be collected by your next ship, and then they will be added to the available team for that. Again, I'll stress that once they're dead, they're dead. If your ship blows up, then that's it. You've got to start again with a new ship. The crewmates are the same. Once they die, they restart at a low level. So you got to go through the grind again. The only thing that carries over is the upgrades for the ship. So when you start the game, you only start with those two, the autocannon MK1 and the plasma cannon MK1. As you progress, you get research. As you do missions, you get research. You got to go scan phasmid ruins. There's a number of things you can do to increase your research rate, but generally you do just increase that over time. And you unlock more, so this progress doesn't get lost. If you get wiped, then you can start where you finished essentially, in terms of your progress through that, but you do have to attain the funds to do that. Engines I'll go to, and I've got a standard engine MK2, which an improved standard engine has improved evasiveness and armoring. It will leak a large amount of radiation if damaged. Radiation is what I was talking about earlier, where when they get damaged, it leaks radiation into the ship, which is dangerous for the crewmates. You want ideally semi-reliable engines, because once they take damage, they are a pain to fix. So I'm going to upgrade that. Okay, so we'll get into the mission and I'll talk you through a bit of what goes on in space. So today I'm going to be taking the plunge. I don't fancy my chances on this mission, but you know, content. So I'm going to be going to the Phasmid Mothership. It's a very high risk. The furthest I've gone is a high risk and I struggled, so I have a feeling that this might wipe my team, but at least you can see the consequences of getting a bit ahead of yourself, I suppose. So without further ado, I'm gonna begin this mission and see how far I get. Okay, so I'll go over the roles again. You've got the gunners, so I can focus fire, which increases the aim accuracy of the crew. There's overdrive, which increases effectiveness but causes a radiation leak or risk of fire, which, going back to radiation again, is a bit of a risk. As you can see, there's only two gunners, but we have four cannons. So what you need to do is drag a member of your other crew members into the guns when they have time. That's why I've made Santos his secondary skill a gunner. I've also made our security officer Wright a gunner. So when they are not in those positions that, or when they're not needed for to carry out their duties as engineer or security, then they can man the guns and take down enemy Phasmid ships. I've also got a rifle there, which is what I normally do before I venture out. I pick up the gun and I just drop it there so that it slides about a bit, but it generally stays in the room because it's, when the Phasmid's bored, it becomes very difficult to go and collect it with them shooting at you, so it's good to just be able to jump out. This is normally my first line of defense for that. They usually fire a few shots into the gunner and then venture off to destroy electrics there, and the O2 and the others. So that's the O2. That's, if that gets destroyed, that needs fixing urgently, usually by anyone can fix it, but essentially the engineer is the guy, is the go-to guy, because he does it a lot quicker than everyone else. Then you've got the shields. Again, if you are under heavy fire by a lot of ships and the shields go down, you're in trouble. You need to get that fixed like as soon as possible. And then you've got gravity, which for me is less essential. It's a bit irritating having people flying about the ship because it sort of, they overshoot where they need to go a lot of the time, but it's bearable. So the engineer has he can boost. So what that does is it gives you more points into your reactor power routing. So you can whack it into shields or weapons. The description for this is more weapon power increases the effectiveness of energy weapons. And the shields is more shields power increases the rate at which your shields recharge. Alternatively, you can put it into engines. More engine power increases your ship's evasiveness. Or you can put it into gravity, which obviously produces gravity into the ship as long as the gravity conduit, whatever you want to call it, works. Then you have the captain can do evasive piloting, which increases the ship's evasiveness. The level of your individual characters adds to the percentages that they offer. So the gunners, their weapon effectiveness is a lot higher at this level than it would be at a lower level. Same with the evasiveness of the pilots. Then when you're flying for asteroid shields, you're less likely to get hit. The comms can perform scans, they can call in fighter support, and all of these characters, this is all that's unlocked for me at the moment. So there is still stuff which I'm going to leave you to discover yourself. I don't want to spoil everything for you. So let's launch into space. SS Sentry Eagle launching for duty. Okay, so at the moment we are orbiting Earth, as you can see. So what it presents two routes for you. So it presents a safest route and a fastest route. The only difference between the two, well, there is a big difference between the two. The safest route, it takes you around the block. It really, instead of having about two or three jumps to get to your location. You have to go for about six or seven, but you find a lot less difficult mobs to go through on your way. Fastest route, it takes you two or three jumps, but it's you're in for a rough time. So obviously I'm going to be going for the fastest route. So I didn't really touch over what I just did there. So if you press the middle mouse button, it brings up tagging. This is probably the main feature when flying around in space. You use this to tag enemies. You do this to tag locations you need to go to. And the game can get quite fast paced and quite heavy on the demand. So if you look at the top, you've got slow time, which it expires the longer you toggle it. And you've got accelerate time, which as long as you're out of combat, you can have it go in indefinitely until you get to your location. As you noticed, I'm near the warp point, so I'm going to hyper jump. I'm going to charge the hyper jump. When you're in combat, the hyper jump takes a lot longer to activate, which is where the fast jump charge comes into play, which drastically increases the speed of charging for hyper jump while enemies are present. So now I'll engage, and what this will do is this will send me over to the asteroid belt Alpha. Okay, so we have got our first sign of enemies here. Phasmids are incoming, so I'm just going to make sure everyone is in position to where I need them to be. Eventually the enemies are going to pour in, and I'm going to slow down time in order to action my crew where I need them. Just hoping that, so I'm going to set, if you notice that it's on 10% evasiveness, I'm going to set that to defensive, and then that should, there you go, it should boost it up. Okay, so I'm going to tag the enemies. That's one tag. It's in slow motion, so that's why it's going so slow. And now I'm going to boost my reactor so I can drag him out into the weapon. I'm going to drag security officer right into the fourth gun. So now all the ships are gunned. All the guns are manned, sorry. And I'm going to start tagging all the other enemies that come into play. Again, I don't know how far I'm going to get into this. I've never started a job that is this far out of my depth. And now I'm going to watch the chaos unfold. Okay, focus fire from all my gunners. Okay, we've got some, our front shield is taking damage, which presents there. How are we looking? Okay, so I'm going to call in some fighter support. Performance analysis increases the XP that you earn. I'm going to need to go evasive pilot in here, and I'm going to need to get right onto his station so that he can regenerate our shields. All of these cooldowns have, all of these skills, sorry, have a cooldown, which some take longer than others, evidently, depending on how impactful they are. Evasive piloting is quite a. Oh, get carried away talking. Make sure that everything's accounted for there. Fixed fire's good. How are we looking? Shield's looking good. So at this moment in time, the shield's looking okay. I'm going to be honest, I have no idea what that is. I haven't seen that before. Because of the difficulty that I'm playing on at the minute, I feel that I may be facing enemies that I have not before seen. So this may become problematic for me, but tackle it when it comes to it. Okay, we've got more enemies that we need to tag. Okay, so yeah, you notice the tagging system is used to basically paint the targets for your gunners to shoot them down. Okay, so we're looking a bit dangerous at the minute. No way. Okay, these are all on cooldown, so I'm gonna spot up there. Okay. More enemies come in. We may not get through the through the first combat, but we'll see how it goes. Right, we're taking some radiation damage here. I may need to evasive pilot. Okay, cool. Let's get our shields back regenerated. We've got no damaged parts of them out there, which is probably it. So I'm going to wait for that to be able to replenish shields. may not need to. Oh god, we've got a lot more enemies coming. Okay. I have no idea what these are. This is obviously what was sticking to the ship a minute ago. I have a feeling these produce radiation when striking the ship, which will damage the crewmates. So I'm hoping. Oh, hold on. Okay, so we've got a lot of enemies here. Unfortunately, we're also flying through an asteroid shield, which becomes its own problem. So it's not ideal for the situation. I think I maybe should have gone for the safer route, but you know. Oh, there we go, there's an asteroid. Okay, I'm going to need to replenish shields now. Have we got any parts that are taking hits? Shields replenishing. Can we basically... Nah, still got a long while yet. Okay, well, I mean the enemies are getting destroyed. I'm just hoping that there isn't too many adding to it. If you notice that I spend a lot of my time slowing the game down where and when I can, because this game is very fast paced and literally within seconds your shields can be depleted, so you need to be focusing a lot of places at once. It's very... Okay, so these aren't radiation stickers, these are just fly around the ship and be a nuisance. Okay, so we've got front side shields down. Should be okay. I think we should be past this. Make sure nothing's getting damaged. Yep, so it's looking great. Once these are destroyed. So we've had no boarding ships as of yet, which is positive. They're usually the ones that do the most damage to me. Front shield, nothing is destroyed yet. Two more ships. I don't think we should regen shield faster than we lose it at this point. Unless any more enemies come. As you can see Earth in the distance. There's quite an attention to detail in this game, to be fair. Straight on, that should be an easy kill. And lastly, ship again. Final one. Shields down. Come on, guys, you're playing up. Station. That's another thing in this game, you can often feel guilty just by forgetting to do something. You get carried away looking at the beauty of the big battles. Okay, so to the objective. What I like to do on this bit, so when you first start on the game it might be wise to try a few of these ideas. I will line up to go to the next location and I will just make sure that I use this time to heal up. Oh, no, don't do that. Stow that away. Okay, so we need to repair this. That's what I use this time for, is essentially maintenance on the ship. Just make sure that everything's above board, make sure everything's to the maximum health that it can be, both crewmates and ship parts, because if you go into a fight with damaged parts, you're in trouble. So I'll take turns, everyone that needs healing, I'll drag them to the med bay, and when that's said, eventually that will say enemy incoming. That's what this means, that there is enemy phasmids that are about to warp in on my location. So once that is charged, then you can immediately jump. There is no charge time once it's already charged. It's an immediate jump. So you can get prepared, let your cooldowns come into effect, like fighter support there, focus fire. I think that should be fine. But yeah, so performance analysis is a big one for leveling your guides up. Fighter support is hella useful, because basically what it does is you call in a number of ships to fight by your side. That was probably, once the fighter ships were taken out of action in the previous fight, that was when we started having a bit of a a dodgy situation. But as you can see, we've done all right. The reactor health is max, so despite all the carnage, we're actually left quite above board. Enemies incoming, as you can see. So what I'm going to do now, I'm going to charge, and that should be fine now. So I'm going to engage the hyper jump, and I'm going to go to the next place. And we're probably going to encounter more enemies, but you know, content. Let's just hope that they're not too difficult. Enemies incoming. So straight off the bat, I'm going to take a defensive position. So what that means is it tries to aim your ship towards the enemy where it's the highest shield. So if your front's damaged, it'll try to turn it to the side, so it won't be your front that's taking the hits. There we go, we've got enemies incoming. There's them tagged. Oh, I should have got into position there, so that's me getting carried away. So call in more fighter support. Let's get boosts going for weapons and shields. Getting back in position there. Focus fire on everyone. Focus fire. So because the security officer and my engineer have, they are also gunners. They can owner. What's that? They can also have focus fire and stuff that is exclusive to the gunners. Otherwise, and they also increases their shooting accuracy, which if I hadn't made them that, then it would have been almost a wasted spec, because it's all I really have them doing outside of their roles. I need to put evasive maneuvering on. So what evasive maneuvering it does is, if you watch now, my guy's going to be flying around evading all bullets. Increases the evasiveness up to all the way up to 100% for me. Just keep tagging enemies, make sure that they're going down. We need to make sure there's no boarding ships, because they are quite problematic. It doesn't look like we're having too much inventory time. As you can see, the fighter support is there chipping away at the enemy's health. Okay, evasiveness 10%, okay. Why has it gone on 12? Well, that's nothing. Okay, shields are looking okay. All the components of the ship are okay. Fighters are still doing their thing. I think we should be alright on this fight. This doesn't seem as hard as the last one. Yeah, this game is it's very hands-on. You've got to pay attention to every last detail, and I like that. It doesn't leave you snoozing. Admittedly, sometimes the firefights can feel a bit repetitive, but yeah, you still enjoy each firefight you need. And I think the concern is there for over losing your ship, because if you lose your ship or you lose your crew, you've got to essentially start again. So you kind of, each firefight is unique in the sense that you're sort of, you're almost fighting out of desperation, almost like you would in real life. You're desperate for that survival. And this carries over onto this game. So that was a relatively easy fight. So we're on to the next bit. One thing is getting to the objective, and then you get filled with this sense of pride and achievement that you finally managed to complete this objective. Sometimes you get to the objective and your ship is in an absolute state, and then you complete the objective, you get that initial sense of pride, and suddenly you get the realization that, I gotta head back now. And that poses a problem in itself, because it's essentially, you gotta go through a load of fights and a load of phasmid hordes to get back. Again, I'm gonna launch the charge, and what is this gonna do? Ready for hyper jump. So what that means now is, if any enemies income, I can just bolt instantly. If you notice, the gun is still stayed put. So essentially, that if any enemies come through those doors, I can immediately pick up that gun and help fend them off, and they can cause minimal damage to the ship as possible. So I'm not actually getting everyone in position, I'm busy talking. Okay, so when you engage the hyper jump, what it does is it disables the lesser parts to your ship. So it disables the shields, it disables your gravity, and it disables the guns. So it's only temporary. Obviously, if you get under a firefight, then it can become a bit problematic, like we're about to now if I don't engage. So wait for them to launch in, and then I will leave. Just get that fighter support up, because this is going to be one of the big fights. Again, I feel this may be out of my depth, but you know. Don't ask, don't go. And go. As you see, the enemy's just dropped onto the radar, so you know that. What are we dealing with here? Oh dear. That's the enemy mothership. It's huge. You'll need to focus on its shield generators first. Okay. Maybe the end of the road, guys. Not gonna lie. Okay, let's just head towards the ship. We need to take down the... Okay, it's automatically locked on. That's okay. Let's get him to defensive position. We've got enemies incoming. I can't unfortunately call on reinforcements. I'm going to have to follow the ship. So that's... No, I'm going to kill the extras before I start. So zoom out. Quick look what's going on. Shield is still 49%. Evasive maneuvering. There we go. Let's get these ships done. Okay. I don't need to replenish shields yet. Get you on to boost weapons. Okay. I'm going to keep getting rid of the ships making ground. If I keep getting rid of the ads. Hopefully it will just leave me and the boss to do our business. One ship has enhanced shields around its reactor. Destroy the shield generators around another ship before attacking the reactor. Shield is still doing alright. Okay, so luckily, because our captain is 7, it's our space ship evasiveness and the way we construct the ship. The evasiveness of the ship is automatically on 20%, which is decent enough. Means the majority of shots fired towards us do miss. I mean, the majority, the minority. But a good portion. Seems we're doing alright, we're not getting bogged down yet. One thing I will note with the tagging is it is very easy to accidentally hit over a waypoint and it takes you off defensive and it starts heading towards that location. It happened a minute ago and it's quite frustrating, but it could be a me problem as opposed to the game's problem. Fighter support's available, get it. Performance analysis as well would help level people up. We've got 20% front shield, may need to replenish shield eventually. What are you looking there? Plenty of shield on the go before we start damaging parts. Okay. We're starting to take a bit more damage now, so I'm going to throw that in there. Focus fire. I was hoping to use this on the boss, but hopefully if the ads stop coming, then we can just deal with the boss over time. The back shield is taking some hits. We've got some damage on the ship. I'm going to need to drag the engineer out, get the reactor. That's essential to it. If that gets destroyed, then we're gone. Same with the shield. If the shield goes, then you're in a lot of trouble because you have to fix it whilst not regenerating any shield whatsoever. I'm going to be honest, if I lose any crewmates out here, I don't think I'm going to come back from anytime soon. Okay, we're still taking hits. Got no basic maneuver in. Fire supports are still on the go. Can't do that yet. I may have to go stealth at this point, though, actually. I'm going to hold out. I'm going to hold out. Side shields, place movement still well off. Okay, we haven't actually got any damaged parts yet. Maybe famous last words. I'm hoping there's a lot of shit blowing up around us, but now we've just lost our fighter support. Okay. Our shields. I'm gonna go ghost. So what that does is it makes us invisible. What enemies don't shoot at us, enemies don't board us. They leave us to do our business for a little bit, for a short period. So now I was hoping to use this when we were in a more of a situation, because it's very useful when the engines go down, but at this moment I don't want to get to that stage. The stealth mode has a fairly respectful cooldown. It's not too bad, but it's long enough that we could take an absolute pounding once we got our stealth, and then it could be game over. So everything should have used that time to heal. No, he's taking hits. Okay, we're not in bad position. So what this does is it cools down a lot of our evasive pilot in. Maybe not player support. Focus fire gets a bit of cooldown. As soon as it comes out of stealth, then the fighting resumes. There we go. Unfortunately, it does feel like enemies are joining. Oh dear, it's injured. Enemies are joining as we kill them, it feels like. I'm hoping this isn't going to go on forever. Maybe I should start focusing the ship, but I feel that if I have to do that, I wouldn't stand a chance on that. There's a reason that this is class is very hard. Okay, evasive maneuvering, let's go. Still well from there. Plenty of shields. Gonna have to be done. I like to do these at different times because when you're evasive maneuvering, you're dodging all the shots, it does naturally recover. So maybe I should have done that, but you know, this game is very punishing for mistakes. If you make a mistake, then you a lot of the time live to regret that to a degree. How are we looking? It's not looking too bad, there's not too many. Maybe we are making progress after all. Unless I mean, can we stop? Come on now, there we go. They're taking hits. More enemies coming back, unfortunately. I am hoping that. Is that a boarding? No. Well, so now. Focus fire is expiring. That was a good focus fire. That's been very productive. Our ship's not looking too bad. The overall health, the shield's obviously depleting again, and I don't know what we can really do about that yet. Not much we can do. I think we're just going to take it at this point. Should have stayed. Okay, at least they're shooting the rear of the ship at this point. They're all on the rear of the ship, so it gives that time to regenerate for a while. Oh, put on swimming. And they're flying straight on, so what you notice when they're flying straight on, it's not shooting anyway. But when it fires and they're flying straight on at you, it lands an awful lot. Don't turn side on. Or turn side on. Okay. Oh, more enemies. I think we've ever been treated. Maybe worth me turning my attention over to a basic pilot in. Let's get that fixed before it becomes an issue. So what happens when they get damaged, the electrical sockets and any part for that matter, is it runs the risk of causing a fire on the ship, which you need to tackle immediately, otherwise it again, it becomes a bigger issue. Essentially, a lot of the stuff in this game is you need to tackle it early before it becomes a big issue. Remaining alert, being very proactive instead of reactive. Okay, we've got this nearby, so I'm just going to start taking some shot at this. No, I don't want to follow it, It does automatically shoot it, so okay, I'll leave that on defensive for now. Kovalchuk's taking a lot of hits. The problem is now all of our shields are down. So, fighters cannot come quickly enough. At the moment, it's just a case of surviving. Don't know how long we've got. Stealth mode can be reused, which maybe I'm going to replace shields for now. Stealth mode can be reused, which is very positive. So purge is what I was saying about earlier, that I can rinse parts of the ship, which kills everyone in them. I've not had to do it yet, and I don't plan to anytime soon. It's almost a last resort to get rid of the invading Phasmid forces. Okay. It may be worth using now. I'm still going to hold out. I'm going to go repair that. Make some movement. Yeah. So we've got no more additions there. Still not things. Okay. Evasive pilot. That can be kicked in now. Unfortunately, I can't replenish shields, but at least we can hear that it's sending a decree. Shields back up. You need the shields to be in tip top form. Next time I go stealth, I think I'm gonna have to send him to. Is he still his body? Seems like we're still taking it. Okay, that's good. Good to go. Engine's still fine, which again is another very good thing. Focus fire. Good, get the focus fires down. Focus fire. Taking some hits there. Fighter support so close. Fighter support. Performance analysis though. If we make it through this, we'll get more XP. It doubles, I believe, the XP earned from each kill. But to get more XP, we're going to need to survive this encounter first. Fighter support's inbound, so that's ships that are going to come and help our cause. I'm hoping the fact that we're automatically popping shots off at this ship means that it's still taking damage, and eventually it's just gonna. Okay, now we've got a problem. Lisa, I'm gonna need to go stealth here, I think. Go stealth mode activate. We've got the fighter pilots that can do their business whilst we're inactive. I was hoping to also be able to assist them in the fight, but we'll get that fixed before it starts to fire. Let's get the spacesuit on. Ooh, I put it too far away. Spacesuit. Need to get you on that bit as well. Okay, let's get that fixed. It doesn't take too long. And immediately out of coming. I can't go into evasive maneuver with him on there, otherwise he will fly off the ship and we need to go collect him. I believe that was what happened last time I did it. So I need to get him back on board. Let's get him there. Get him back in the ship. And evasive pilot. There we go. Let's get him back in. Nope, let's get him onto this. Weapons. Nope, so boost. Weapons. Shields. Okay, let's back focus. Again, I need to slow the game down a little bit. Let's get back on guns, that should be enough. I'm going to give you a medkit. Oh, maybe I shouldn't have done that. I used my medkit. Ooh, okay. Big mistake. He was in the middle of using evasive maneuvering, and now I've taken him off, which cancels his evasive maneuvering, and it starts to cool down again. That is my first big mistake in there. Could be costly. Okay, they're straight on, if you notice the gun, the shots are ooh. Taking it, so I didn't put him back in the gunner suit. I'm gonna have to do this in mid-flight. I can't use stealth again. I'm gonna have to replenish shields on him. Obviously, if you go out into space without the spacesuit, then your guy, the yellow bar depletes. And if it hits zero, your guy dies. And when you come back into the ship, it regenerates back to its current state, which is the max. So when I get in, the yellow go. Yeah, everyone's okay. More ships incoming. I don't feel I'm doing any significant damage to the boss. Maybe we're going in circles. I'm hoping that we can just keep this going. Grinding out. Evasive pilot in there. Recharge. Focus fire. Let's get some focus fire. We're in proximity to the ship, so we're going to be taking little pot shots at it. I'm hoping that the shield don't regenerate on the ship, because otherwise I don't feel we are doing enough damage to drain its shield or something. Ooh, we've done it again. It's okay, we're on the basic pilot here, so I can go defensive as soon as this expires. Defensive. The ship's looking alright, everyone's apart from you, unit's position, typical. Let's get you focus firing as well. Okay. I am still hoping that there is going to be an end to these Phasmids. And they're just going to leave their mothership to 1-1 situation. But I don't think that'll be the case. Shields down there and see if he can regenerate. Okay, urgency. Stealth mode's back up, which is another positive. I may need that in a second. Come on. Let's get the engineer back on that. More enemies. Only one. Get it back soon. Okay, I'm gonna have to get him into the med kit. Let's get some penalties here. Don't stop it. Okay, back shield's taking more damage. How long till we fight some more? Okay, I'm not too bad. I feel that. Still quite cool though. I may need to go stealth in a second. I'm gonna wait for the parts to actually become damaged before I do that. At least we are sitting on top of the ship. Okay, we've just taken one out. Oh, we're taking two out. So, taking little pot shots is working. Slowly, very slowly, but it's working. Okay. Stay on defensive. And the shield is going to be available soon. I'm just going to have to hang on for this. Come on. 0% shield. Nah, my blood is pumping. Right, okay. Oh, okay, all the shields are down. Oh, we still got underneath though. Oh, that was actually quite good. But okay. Yeah, we're making... we're making progress. Let's get that prepared. More enemies incoming. How's our actual health? Our health's looking alright. So we haven't actually taken damage to it. Focus fire. I'm gonna get a foot of laser maneuvering on. Hopefully get a bit more shield back. Flight support's so close. Cause analysis. We may just do it. Which is a incredibly satisfactory. Satisfying, should I say. everyone's doing their part. Everyone's doing their part. Good bunch of guys and girls. Unfortunately, the pilot seems to be taking us away from the ship, which isn't what I wanted. And shields yet? I'm hoping. I haven't needed to go into stealth for a while, which means that we do appear to be winning. Okay, we can level stealth. Absolute fool. Okay. Absolute muppet. Let's get him space. Space suit. That was a big mistake. So what happened was I did stealth mode and then I tried putting him in guns for some reason, so it cancelled his stealth mode. And now we're in a bit of trouble. Luckily his shield is still there, so we should get back in. I can't do evasive maneuvering yet until he's back in the ship. He's got his work cut out for him. Old Santos, he's got his work cut out for him. Okay. Evasive pilot in. Fighter sports. Now you can go, buddy. Looks fast and cool down. We've got fighters incoming, so which is very painful. Okay, let's get you back in there. Rose. Let's get you healed. Okay. Who else needs healing? We're running low on them. We need the engineering fighters. Unfortunately, if any gets knocked down at this point, they're gone. Like, we can't heal anyone else because the med kits are there to revive people as well. And there are no med kits, no revives. Are we looking for some pilots? The fighter's still here? We still got the fighter inside. Unfortunately, the ship still has those two underside shields. Two side shields are taking hits. Okay. Ooh, O2's taking shots as well. Okay. No, not you. Come on. Get him there. Something just blew up. Hope that's the underside of the ship. Yeah, every little bit. Okay, we've lost our fighter pilots. Okay, shields. Okay, we got stealth mate back. That's good. Next time I'm going to make sure I don't screw that up as bad as I did. He's also got focus fire, which will be useful step ones. Shields are up. Okay, these ships definitely are never ending. So I do need to. We are still scattering shots at the ship though, so. And it does appear that they also don't reject. Oh, we've knocked one. Okay. One left. Is the other side of the ship. Do I go out? Ship down. Okay, do I go out? Or do I go sleep? I'm gonna go out. I'm gonna risk it. Ooh, okay, I've done it again. Base pilot in the country. No! And that is a prime example. One or two. Can't go and collect him either. He's gonna take damage, I'm gonna have to get him out of there. There's the radiation leak. I may have single-handedly screwed myself up here. I'm gonna wait for the evasive maneuvering to go. He's not under fire, luckily. Get you. stealth mode activate. Where is it? Let's get it back. Are you heading towards him? We are. Okay, I've really stitched myself up here. Again, everyone can fix the ship, but it's primarily best to leave it to your engineer because it goes a lot faster. I need to get him into cargo, and as soon as it lines up, retreat. And that's a prime example of faulting concentration. Oh god, I still need to go out and fix it. What happened to his suit? I've lost his suit. They're not a evasive pilot. Can you replace shield? Oh yeah, also forgotten about tagging now. Falling apart. One thing goes south, everything goes south. Okay, let's get him back in. I even sent the wrong person out. Focus fire. Everyone's in the ship, make sure. Oh my god, that was a lot of damage. Let's get the shields back operational, that's a must. Luckily we are evasive pilot. So excess shots won't be knocking out the shield. As you can see, now the O2 is out, now the gravity is out. We are flying around the ship. Though. Defense. How are we looking? At least we can land shots on the other side. Did you do your fixing duty there, buddy? As you can see, the radiation damage is still there. Again, it's so easy when things start going south to forget about what you need to do. So I'm going to go into stealth for a second. I'm going to get back into where I need to be. Get that repaired. So you can get healed. We've got 7 seconds left, let's get it tagged. Okay, I'm gonna just get in from the end. 4, 3, 2, 1. Boost. Weapons. Shield. Back to guns. Back to guns are really useful there. Evasive pilot, okay. Unfortunately, the captain's also very injured. He's not as easy to heal. Get some focus fire over there. but I feel I should probably save that until I'm near the ship. Okay. Just the shadow, just the silhouette. He's done it again, it's locked off. Unfortunately, if I set a course for that point that I need to destroy, then it makes us an easy target because we can't evade. So I'm just taking it slow. Fighter sport's back in action, okay, cool. Cool, preparing for engagement. Stealth mode is back available as well. Good, good, good. Unfortunately, I'm a bit concerned about helping my captain. Not so concerned about the health of the ship, the ship's doing great. Just gonna have to wait this one out. Just get him on it. Okay, we do have a medkit. I need to find the right time to use it though. Do as much damage as I can. I'm hoping that my pilots there are also going to find some shots of that, but it doesn't look like they've got engines. Yeah. Right, I'm going to have a little rain check on these guys. I may go through one focus fire first. Come on, guys. Give it your all. Focus fire your heart. Starts getting south, we're gonna have to. Luckily that time I waited there for the evasive party to finish. I was so close to just sending them out again. I need to go stealth, I need to go stealth. I didn't put a spacesuit on. Oh my god. Imagine. Don't know what I can do here. He's guaranteed to die. May have absolutely shot myself in the foot here. Go on, do your damage. You're next, you're about to go. You're gonna have to go do your thing. I'm gonna get you in stealth mode. I have no idea what just happened there. Okay. I can't answer that one. I have no idea what happened. Maybe it was radiation damage. Okay, but that makes sense. I think at this point, gonna have to try and evacuate. See if I can get out of this. I think it might be game over. It was all going so well. No stealth charge left. No supply. Fortunately, I've got leaking radiation onto the ship. It does seem to stop there though. But it will hinder our movement. You know what? We're gonna fight out. Absolute fight out. At least try to take the ship with me. In for a penny. I'm wasting everything here. Wasting everything. Panicking. This game's got to me. Let's get that fixed. I'm just gonna get that repaired. Anything to... No, it's not good. What the fuck's been going on? This moment I'm not even sure I want to start firing these guys. I really focus my attention on that ship. Come on. Okay. That was a big shot again. We've got a new mechanic on board. Unfortunately, this run it does appear that I've been my own worst enemy. Got off to a good start, stayed consistent, but as soon as things went south, it just panic mode set in. But that's a good part of the game. You sort of learn the patterns, things become second nature, and you feel that real sense of progression and improvement. Our dead buddies. Die valiantly. As will these guys soon, by the looks of it. Ooh. Stealth mode. One final push. Unfortunately, I did want to use that medkit on my main guy, my captain. Back in the captain's chair, get that locked on. Unfortunately, I've got 10 seconds to repair that engine. Almost called in fight support. I can't do evasive maneuver. Fight support bound. I can at least replenish my shield to give myself some. He may be in trouble now. He's about to die. No gunners left on the ship. literally our last levels now. Focus fire. So close. So close, it's so far. Knocked our shields out again. When is Stokely leaving? I think this may be the end of the road. Perhaps leak in. We have to help bleed in. Poor Santos. Poor Benin. Poor Coventry. And in a minute. Poor crew. Okay. Basic pilot is not an option. Shield's an option yet? No. So close. Do I wait? Do I not? I think once the captain dies, then it's good done. Okay, at least our shield and O2 is intact. Nothing else is. Ooh, sick. I just got that back. Thank you very much. Basically, it's getting back on guns because they're maybe not doing any damage. Also, I'm going to need to get those. Get things repaired. Rose, I'm afraid you're the martyr here. That is a hell of a lot of radiation. Captain's dead. You know what? I can't be miles away from the ship. Game over, Rose. Let's try and get you out. Get you to the escape pod. You're a brave man, right? You're a brave man. Watch his final moments. So close, guys, so close. Almost at it. But you know, losing is part of the game, essentially. So it's all part of the learning curve. So we got Finn Rose back, which is a bonus. She auto-recovered. If she didn't auto-recover, then what happens is she gets stuck in space and we have to go retrieve the escape pod when we can. And then we'll get her back. Unfortunately, we lost our captain. We lost our weapons officer, both of them. We lost our security officer and we lost our engineer. But we kept our comms. So now I'm going to recruit a new team. And as you can see, they've all started at a lot of a lower level than who our veteran is. So now we just have to get all the gear up to date. Unfortunately, our new spaceship is going to be lacking in features. It's going to be pretty... It's looking okay. It's looking okay. It's not as bad as I thought it would be. It does look like it gives you some upgrades. It's not to the standard it was, but I haven't lost everything. So it gives you a little bit of leeway. But the idea of the game is you sort of, if you lose crew, if you lose your ship, then it wants you to go back to a place where you need to progress. I think it wants to, it doesn't want to make it impossible, because the lower, the previous low risk missions would be absolutely unreachable if it was to reset you back to square one. But it does want you to have to earn where you were back again, which makes sense. Anyway, thanks for watching, guys. I hope you enjoyed the video. I will be... Oh, I don't mind making more gameplay videos upon release. I've given you a nice little preview of what the game has to offer. I'm sure everyone's showing you their victory tales and their brave heroics taking on certain enemies, certain bosses. But I guess now you get to see a nice change of pace and watch someone actually capitulate into a nervous wreck and lose everything. So, you know, every cloud. Cheers for watching, guys, and I'll see you soon.